I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
But you know what's funny? Speaking of Robert Easter, he reached out to you before he turned pro.
Yeah.
And he used to be, I remember when he was just a kid and he didn't have a pro fight yet.
Yeah.
One fight, two fights. You guided him, you groomed him from day one. He did the work, he got the knockout, but you believed in him.
People don't even know, man. Like, it brings me to tears just to see him on this stage.
Shining like that.
Shining. Like I don't like the show me crying, but like it really make like, it bring tears to my eyes, because at the end of the day, like, we really, like, the way he hit me, that message, I remember it from day one. He was so serious. You know what I'm saying? Get me, I need to be with you. And I'm just like, the next day he was with me.
But Adrien, you probably get, I'm not joking, tens of thousands of messages.
Yeah.
And you probably can't read all of them and can't respond to all of them. What was it about Robert Easter Jr.'s message versus...
It was so sincere, man.
But you get a lot of crazy people too.
No, but you gotta understand, I knew him I was about 8 years old, a kid, you know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? I'm 10 years old, he's younger than me, he's fighting, you know what I'm saying? This one, he wore the glasses. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? A lot of motherfuckers don't. You know what I'm saying?
I talked to him tonight. You know what he told me?
This is my baby brother, man. This one, he wore the glasses.
He was fighting with glasses?
And I'm going through these weigh-ins, and they in the front of me, and I'm like, look, me and my twin brother, and we like, look,
yeah.
Man, we taking these spots, man. Mm-hmm. We in front of all y'all. They ain't gonna say nothing to me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Since I'm crazy, you know what I'm saying? But anytime I see him fight, I'm like, damn, this dude can fight. He can be better than that. I'm like, man, he can. So then he hit me, and I'm like, I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna do something for him. I know I'm taking a chance. He ain't shit right now, but I know I can make him something. I don't care if he at the top or almost at the top. I know I can make him some. Because I seen it. I'm like, damn, he's better than what I'm doing. I can make him some. Then, boom, he come around me. This is crazy.
Always smiling.
It's going to be in my movie. It's going to be in my movie. He come around me. He got on a big-ass black hoodie. Some big-ass black sweatpants. I'm like... I let it slide for a day or two, maybe 3 days. Boom. Go to the club. He go to sleep in the club because the Cincinnati, at that time, we had a club called the Ritz that stayed open. But I don't like white girls, but I love her. You know what I'm saying? I love her. Miss Louis-Bez, I'm not cheating on you. She worked for me.
She's with the PR team. I can tell them.
So... We go to the club, and the club stay open till 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, whatever we want to close it. So it's his first time around me. So we partying, and I look around, and he's asleep. He's asleep. I'm like, damn, what time club closes in Toledo? He said, 2 o'clock.
That's most places around the world.
Man, I promise
you. So I'm like, all right, I give him a pass. And then 3 days later, you know, I had just bought this condo for like $185,000 for change or whatever. So we staying at the house. So 3 days later, I'm like, we about to go somewhere. It's when I first got with Eric, Miss Louis Bags. Mm-hmm. He was around when we first started rocking. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So he put on his outfit. We was about to go somewhere. I think she was meeting me there or whatever. I'm like, baby bro, you got to start dressing different.
You
know what I'm saying? I'm like, you gotta start dressing different. I took him to the mall instantly. And from then on, it's just been, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, I really groomed him to be the guy he is. Like, don't get me wrong, his dad made him the man he is. You know, he taught him so much. And he still, you know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, like, you know, I'm a big influence in his life. I love him. He loved me. And you know, we rocking together. Win, lose, draw, whatever.
And you know what? More important, not only he's a great fighter, he's a great person. He's very positive.
He's a hell of a person. And he's smarter than what people think, man. He's very intelligent.
You're right.
And I tell him all the time, I said, man, listen, man, you just need to let the people see that side of you when you with me. Because when you with me, fuck a fool. We some damn fools, man.
He jokes. He's a jokester. And look, you're a good friend because at the club, you could have taken a picture. You could have put a beer bottle in. We've seen it happen.
You know what I'm saying? Exactly. But, you know, we some damn, we like to have fun, man. And you know, he's opening up now. He's getting more
comfortable. It takes time.
Comfortable with the cameras or whatever. You know, he's gonna be good though.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rockin' with the best. Ooh, Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. ESNews. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition, he abusing them.